I'm Anastasia and I work for Sparkbox, and today I'm going to go over how to identify a wasted render in your React app to help with performance issues. So what is a wasted render? A wasted render is when a component renders and doesn't load anything new. So in a complex React app, these wasted renders can impact performance. To demonstrate this example of a wasted render, I've created a simple coffee loyalty card that every time you click the Add Another Hole Punch button, it will add another punch to the card like this. The first step to seeing these wasted renders is to install React Developer Tools for Chrome. So I already have this open. I'm going to click Add to Chrome, click Add Extension. Close out of this. Now that we have React Developer Tools installed, I'm going to open up the Chrome DevTools and I'm going to go to the React tab. And on this right hand side, you'll see a gear icon, and that's going to bring up a pop-up that lets me check highlight updates. When I click on Add Another Hole Punch, you're going to see an outline around the entire card. And in this scenario, the entire card is being re-rendered even though the hole punches are the only part of this component that changes. Each time state is updated in a React component, the entire component will re-render. We don't need to re-render the title, we don't need to re-render buy 10 coffee drinks, and we don't need to re-render the image, so we can take the punch card list into its own component since it's being frequently updated. In my code sandbox text editor, I have the index file for the card component, which includes the state for the punches. It also includes the button that I was using to add another hole punch. I already went ahead and created the punch component here, which includes the state and it includes the button to add more punches. And I'm gonna go add that to my card component here. Import punch from punch index. I'm going to remove the constructor, get punch list, and then I'm going to add punch here. Now that I've created a punch component, the card component doesn't have to worry about the state of how many punches there are. So when I click add another hole punch, it's showing that only the punch list is being re-rendered and the rest of the card elements stay the same. This example of extracting the punch list into their own component is an easy way to improve performance. I hope this small tutorial helps make your next React app go even faster.